acá. Vendrá ahora, pero estamos iniciando porque ya se nos está haciendo tardes.
Ok. Mamo Rodrigo, por favor, déjame traducir y después continúas. Today, we are here again with the mamos from the Sierra Nevada of Santa Marta. At the moment, we only have two tribes. We have two Wiwa mamos and two Wiwa sagas. Sagas are the equivalent of a mamo, the female equivalent of a mamo. And this ceremony that we are having today will be the completion of a ceremony that was initiated a week ago when the sagas could not invite the mamos to the ceremony because of the momentum that they were, or the event or the happening that they were witnessing. The sagas were witnessing the birth of a new cycle for the water on earth. So they were not allowed to invite the mamos in the space because according to their tradition, at the moment of a birth of a newborn, the males cannot be in the same room. This is a divine feminine or is a completely, a totally feminine event for women only. The moment that a woman is delivering a baby. So that's the reason the mamos were not allowed to be in the same space. So the commitment was to join a week from the moment of birth for the mamos to be invited, and this is today. And the mamos at the moment, Mamo Rodrigo was telling me that at the moment we have two Wiwa mamos and two Wiwa sagas, but they are waiting for two more mamos, Kogi and an Arhuaco, same with sagas, to join the gathering. Today is a very important day for the water in general and for the mamos in the Sierra. Because what is happening today in the Sierra is a very happy event when a newborn receives his or her baptism. So today is the day to baptize this new cycle of the water for the planet that was seven days ago, this new cycle began. The mamos are at the moment waiting, but they are here, and this is something that they will say themselves. They are here to fully support the Global Alliance for a World Water Law. They acknowledge and recognize this movement, and they are also here to invite to this circle of indigenous wisdom keepers in support of the World Water Law. For them, the water is very close to their hearts for several reasons. They recognize water as the most maternal. They recognize water as from the very beginnings because life originated in the water and they are fully aware of that. And as well, the mamos, they have memories to go back to the very the beginning of the origins of this planet. And they said that they were there, here on Earth, where there was only water on the planet. So they said they truly believe that they were birthed from the waters or that they come from the waters. So water is one of the most important elements for the mamos. I'm just waiting for Mamo Rodrigo to officially begin this ceremony. I'm going to tell him that he's waiting for the Kogi mamos and the Kogi sagas. Mamo Rodrigo, ya llegaron los mamos Kogis y las sagas Kogis. Well, Mamo Rodrigo, I don't know if you are aware, but you might be muted. Mamo Rodrigo, creo que estás es en silencio. Creo que tu micrófono está cerrado.
Ya.
Ok, ¿aló? Perfecto. Sí, te estoy escuchando claramente, Mamo Rodrigo.
Bueno, va a hablar aquí Mamo José Martín. Nos va a hablar cómo se bautiza el agua para realizar pagamento y que agua nos cure a nosotros. ¿Cómo se bautiza? Que la lengua llamamos Jira Akushi. Ade Jira Akushi, Jira Kakukwa, Ime Guashi.
Ok.
Adamnam.
Jira Akushi, Kakukwa.
Okay, Mamo Rodrigo is telling us that at the moment, Mamo José Martín Barros, who comes from a lineage of a very old Mamo, José María Cacamucúa, he is going to tell us a little bit how is the baptism of the water. He said that ceremony, they call it the spiritual father of the baptism of water, has a name in their language. It's called Ade Jira Akush. So Mamo José Martín, who is an elder Mamo, he's a Wiwa Mamo that comes from the lineage of the Cacamucúa. So he's going to talk in a few seconds. Okay, Mamo Rodrigo, continúa.
Abujini, el. Agua viene muy cerca, fuerte tormentas. Abujini.
Sí, te estoy escuchando. ¿Tú tienes miedo de que la tormenta, tú me escuchas?
Hola, Abujini.
¿Me escuchas o no me escuchas?
¿Me escuchas?
Yo sí te escucho, pero no sé si tú me escuchas. They got frozen. Mamo Rodrigo was telling me, although I wasn't sure that he was able to listen to me, he was saying that there is a huge storm that is approaching in the Sierra. And the reason why he's telling me that, he's giving me heads up, because normally when we have a tropical storm in the Sierra Nevada, Santa Marta, normally we have problems with the signal. So that's why he was telling me about that. So we'll see.
Abujini,
te escucho, ¿tú me escuchas?
Hola.
Yo te escucho, ¿tú me escuchas? Mamo Rodrigo,
Abujini, yo... con lo... okay, bueno. Sí, así es, estoy escuchando.
Perfecto. ¿Quieres empezar, Mamo Rodrigo? ¿Quieres empezar a darle la palabra al Mamo José Martín? They might have lost connection because I don't see them in the screen. So probably that's exactly what happened. Oh my. The weather is not helping, that's for sure. On the positive side, in a symbolic way, we are going to have a storm, which is in perfect alignment with what is going on at the moment. So. While they come back in the
Abujini,
Sí, estoy aquí escuchándote perfectamente.
Bueno, la dificultad que vamos a tener, lo que estoy mirando es que está tronando muy fuertes. Comienza a haber aguas bastante, pero eso es muy importante porque estos son corticos. Va a hablar, vamos, Martín, a asunto bautizo de aguas.
Ok, gracias. Mamu Rodrigo is saying that we might have technical problems due to the storm that is approaching, but he finds this a very good sign. And at the moment, Mamu Jose Martin is going to talk about what is the meaning of baptizing the water. Continúa, Mamu Rodrigo. We lost him again. This is something that happens often when we have a connection with the Sierra, because it's a tropical place. We have a lot of tropical storms. And in the Sierra, it rains almost every day. So depending on the intensity of the rain, okay, estás de nuevo, te estoy oyendo, Mamá Rodríguez.
I'm on Jira, Jira. Jira is important, Karen. Ya gira iyo giramba ne japuko ne tunukure japuko nanu chimwa dugwa bima dugwa giramba dugwa washi giramba japuko ne tunukure ya iyo chimba mema agwa kupa wekangwa mema gira kwichingu tuna wane gira kwichi tunukwa mba mandamba ne sta ukangwa anjavi aweza gira kwichina wane mba mandamba ne ka ukanjina anjavi gishiri Abi Maya na Waneka, Zombie na Waneka, Kanguinuka na Waneka, Tepa Wego, Siwenjuambaru Mema, 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 Tpizitusa Wego, Shanega, Marunse, Shanega, na Waneka, Wak. Ima Shaneku Kambaru Meku, Wazizina, Bibi Zanuka, Ekungo, Mishizo, Ewo, Pangyo, Gwana, Neka or find one. You are my imagegamba, imagegamba, imagega ya. To a reader, Mbawa Pano Kanji to a reader, let you move. Umba Jakupa Kanji Magegamba Jakupa Nakurashi, Tuna Bidus, Tuna Jakupa Kanjaneka, Nekunkama, Kuman, what? Roman Kaguashiro. Now when it can look on this room, younger much tongue, you own a weather. Now when it connects, however, I'm not a wash you work. Wajinjina, Kawanjina, Ashinjina, Suganjina, Neka, our Pangu Chinese is one, Kura, Kine, one of Pangu is one.
And Bangu, Unjename, Yamashumba, me, Tira de Kapuava, Memo. Memengu meku gula ngusi aru saa au wame kistrega mima shu.
Ma kingu shu. Maru aga ne tantebuna kwa guma uka. Ima. Awanka amba kanzu jira hazi ukwame. Akshel klamba kanzu Dugwane kamba kanju, dugwane kamba gekane kweru, hanpana jane kanana, weru me jingwa kandu, kanami kimungu, shumba togwamba, jiranga nukokwaga kinjane kandu, kinjuengwa nana. Ntima aguma wan, ntima sisa wawin, ntima shungwa sisa wawin, jingwa kandu, weru me kanjengu.
Entonces vamos a poder a traducir, nos está dando las orientaciones, está diciendo mamá, primero, ¿qué hay que bautizar? El calabazo que está presente, si se termina el calabazo, entonces hay debilidad para el agua. Por eso, la ley mundial del planeta es tener calabazo o en la lengua su. Su es la vida espiritual de agua. Sin ellas, hay debilidad para el agua, hay debilidad para nuestras sangres. Por eso, nosotros utilizamos su es damburu. Ahí está el calabacito. Tenemos su para recoger el agua. Y tenemos materiales como esto, que también para hacer las consultas.
Vamos, Rodrigo,
por
espera
eso existe
ahí.
Su. Okay. Para bautizar el agua, para bautizar un bebé, para bautizar la socola, bautizar la finca, bautizar los templos, bautizar sitios sagrados, se necesita aguas de las quebradas, aguas de lagos.
Okay.
Este es muy importante que los hermanitos, hermanitas, conozca las leyes, las normas que nosotros podemos salvar a la madre agua y ellas nos puedan salvar. Esa es la traducción de Mamo José Martín.
Ok. Mamo José Martín, he just began giving us instructions and guidance. The first instruction was, he was talking.
Aló, Abugine, ¿me escucha?
Yo te escucho perfectamente, ya empecé a traducir, Mamo Rodríguez. ¿Me esperas un poquito? ¿Tú me escuchas?
Okay.
Mamo José Martín. He began to point out the first instruction or the first rule or the first step to baptize the water. He immediately... yo te escucho. ¿Tú me escuchas, Mamo Rodrigo? Ok. Yo voy a empezar a traducir ahora, Mamo Rodrigo. Yo te aviso cuando puedas continuar.
Hola, Bujidi.
Oh, obviously you don't hear me. Okay, Mamo Rodrigo, you don't no me estás escuchando, ¿verdad? Okay. Mamo José Martín, he began explaining what are the steps or what are the instructions to follow when we are going to do any baptizing. But to baptize anything, but in this particular case, the baptism of the water. He said that the first rule or the first guidance, he would like us to pay attention to the container. The container they are using at the moment is a gourd. We call that totumo or calabazo. And in the language that they speak, it's called shu. This container or this bowl is very important because it represents the spiritual life of water. They say that the water needs the container. So also it doesn't only represent the spiritual life of water, but it represents the spiritual life of us humans. They said also when the shoe or the ball is weak, that is also a symbolic meaning that we have weakness in our blood. He said that shoe is so important for them that they use it throughout their daily life and especially in sacred ceremonies. He said that shoe represents the poporo or the dumburu. I don't know, but if the people in the call, but the mamos, the priests from the Sierra Nevada and all males, they are always holding in their hands a container made of a gourd. That container is called dumburu or poporo. And that container represents the womb, not only the womb of the women or their wives, also it represents Mother Earth. And it's important that they hold that in their hands when they are having any type of ceremony, or when they want even to calm themselves, when they are a little bit off balance, the mamos immediately will hold that container, because there is the way they see it, it is the womb representing the mother, representing Gaia, but at the same time representing their wife or the woman of their life, give them, ground them, and give them stability, and they honor that. The mamos and the males from the tribes of the Sierra, they honor the divine feminine. So their life through the day are filled with these small gestures, with these small rituals. One of them is the dumburu or the poporo, and they always want to hold one. And that gives them balance and they make feel grounded. And it's a way for them to say that they are honoring the divine feminine, honoring Mother Earth, and honoring the woman in their lives. They said that this container, which is in reality comes from a tree. It's like a pumpkin. We call it a totumo or calabazo. They call it shoe. This container is not only used in the dumburu or the poporo that they always are holding in their hands, but it's also used when they are going to do the jatukwa. Jatukwa is a way that the mamos divine using water. So you will see when they come in the screen, you could see that they have like a little bowl of made with a gourd with water in it. When they need to know exactly what is going to be the script of this ceremony, they will be permanently consulting, divining. And when they look into the water, that act of them divining by looking into the water in a similar way that Nostradamus used to do with a bowl of water, they use that, that is called jatukwa. They said that the jatukwa is very important in their lives. They divine by using water, and they divine by doing for every single sacred ritual or sacred ceremony. They said that another important part of this ceremony is not only the container or the bowl of made of gourd is important, but it's also important the quality of the water. So the water that they use for all their ceremonies, it has to come from a natural source of water, as a lake or as a waterfall. So Mamo Jose Martin, first step in the baptism is the container. The container representing what holds the water, which also talks or symbolizes the spiritual life of the water and the spiritual life of humanity. They said when the container is not strong, when the container is not smooth and is not solid, that means that there is weakness in us. There is weakness in our spiritual life. And also in a physical way, there is weakness in our blood. Mamo Rodrigo, ¿puedes continuar? Mamo Rodrigo, ¿tú me escuchas? Oh, my. We are not having a good signal from the Sierra. Probably because of the storm. Mamo Rodrigo, ¿podrías decirle al Mamo José Martín, si me escuchas, que puede decirnos la segunda instrucción, el segundo paso?
Me escucha.
Perfectamente te escucho, perfectamente.
Bueno, te estoy tratando para buscar señal. Con lo que tenemos es la señal muy malas, malísima. Aquí los mamos dicen lo siguiente. Bajo de la consulta, el día de la primera se hizo una forma con prácticas. Ahora, con esta orientación, es solamente cómo cumplir las prácticas para hacer pagamento.
The mamos are saying first that the signal is very weak, that they are having problems with the signal. They are trying to position themselves, or they already did, to get a better signal. He's saying also that the first, a week ago when they have the first ceremony, it was more of a ritual. I mean, it was a ceremony that was more doing. So we will be, at that time, we were able to see the sagas gathering in a circle and concentrating around the water or blessing the water that they were holding in the gourds or totumos. He said now, Mamo Rodrigo, at the moment, this is not what is going to happen during this this time. He said that what we are is happening during this time is that the Mamo, the leader of the ceremony, who is Mamo José Martín, is going to give us a script or how they need to do, or what is going to, how is the script, what are the steps in order to do the baptism of the water. But this is at the same time, while the Mamo is talking, is giving us a story, there is sacredness and there is activations in their words. And they could call upon the power of the words to make things happen. So sometimes they do a ceremony or a pagamento, the way they call it, just by telling a story. Vamos, Rodrigo, continúa. Vamos, Rodrigo, ¿tú me escuchas?
Sí, escuché bien.
Ok, perfecto. Sí, continúa. Sí, sí.
Bueno, aquí va a hablar a esta traductora, va a hablar aquí, María Luisa, va a hablar aquí las importancias de agua. ¿Cómo queremos que se trate el agua?
Okay. The person who is who will be talking to us is Asada. Her name is Maria Luisa. Well, that is a Spanish name. She has another name, but the Saga Maria Luisa, who is going to tell us about the importance of water, and these stories that they are telling us. This is a ceremony itself. So by saying, by telling us the importance of water, there are things happening at the same time in the other dimensions, in the other realms. Okay, Mamo Rodrigo, estoy esperando por la saga María Luisa.
Habla Saga María Luisa haciendo ejercicio. ¿Cómo se bautiza esta agua?
Okay. This Saga María Luisa is standing and she's going to tell us how to baptize the water. We are losing connection again. So even that we are not seeing them, the ceremony already began and they won't finish, they won't stop it. Because once they open sacred space and once they initiate a ceremony, they won't stop until it's complete, because that will be breaking law. Cosmic law for them, sacred law. So even that we are not seeing what is happening in the Sierra at this moment, I know what is happening. The Saga María Luisa and the Mamos are standing in front of gourds, totumos, or calabazos, or shoe containing water. And by then standing in front of the water, they are doing that. Yes. In reverence to the water. So,
bueno.
Namo Padme. Sentalo amo.
Bueno, de pronto acá vamos a hacer un poco de ejercicio cómo se debe tratar el agua. Y en el
en este calabazo
en este
the saga was saying that they were to show us, they were going to show us how to treat water. And the first word that she used was calabazo, which means a gourd or a container that they use in the Sierra to put water in it. So she was beginning to say, to give us the instructions or the step by step how to treat water. And she was talking about the container, shoe or calabazo or totumo, same thing. And they lost connection, or we lost connection. But I know that they are continuing because that's the way they are. So we have to be very mindful and in our way to honor the water, even if we are not able to have a visual or an image of the ceremony. We could join, and obviously we are joining the ceremony from deep inside our hearts, from that emotional place of reverence and sacredness. So we are joining the ceremony for the water, even if we are not able to see it. Sometimes, because we are visual people and we use our eyes and rely on them every day, sometimes it's better to do this exercise, to close our eyes and be in reverence to the water together from our hearts, joining the mammoths of the Sierra Nevada, because they are right here with us, with a common goal in reverence to the water, to baptize and to acknowledge and honor the sacredness of water. I would like to know that at the beginning, Mamo Jose Martin, he was telling us or pointing out to us the importance of the container, of the bowl. And it's interesting because males in the Sierra, Mamos and any male from any of the tribes, they have this reverence from the womb. I'm from Mother Earth. So that it was very appropriate for him to begin the ceremony speaking about the importance of the womb, the importance of Daya, the importance of the container of water. And they gave us examples for that. First, they pointed out to the container that was holding water. And then they talk about the poporos or the dumburros, which is a sacred object that they are always holding in their hands, the males. And then they also talk about jacuqua, or a bowl of water that they use when they are going to divine. Next is Saga Maria Luisa, because she is a saga priestess and represents the divine feminine. She's allow to talk about water. Most of the time, a mamo wouldn't be talking about water, but a saga, because she's in alignment with the water. So that's why she came next, to talk about the water itself or herself. At the beginning, the mamos also said about the healing qualities of these ceremonies, not only for the planet, but also for each of us and for the human race. So please be aware that we are here in this sacred space together, because called by the water, because it was the water herself who called us, and joining this sacred circle to honor the water. But also there is another aspect, which is the healing that we are receiving in this moment. And as an empath, I could feel it in my entire body at the moment. So if you close your eyes, you could be, might be able to feel it. We are being here, honoring, acknowledging the water and healing us and our inner waters as a representative of the human race. This exercise is, if you could feel better if you close your eyes, it will be better for you. This is a very sacred moment, so let's honor that. Meanwhile, the ceremony is continuing in the Sierra. Things are happening there, even that we don't see it then. Okay, finally. Okay, let's go back. Let's see what is going on. So we need to make a choice now. We could be here waiting for them. Okay, obviously they are coming back. That's good. Okay. As you could see, things are going, are happening in the Sierra, and we have more mammals and more sagas. You might notice that there are many more sagas than mammals at the moment.
Yes. Yes.
Mamo Rodrigo, ¿tú me escuchas?
Sí, estoy escuchando bien.
Ok, perfecto. Continúa, no tenemos imagen tuya, pero bueno, no importa. Vamos exacto. A usar el audio solamente porque tenemos muchos problemas técnicos.
Exacto, tenemos muchos problemas con la señal. Tenemos problemas con la señal. Entonces, llegando aquí, aquí está presente los mamos, aquí está las sagas presente para hacer el toque de la música tradicional, explicando y cómo se bautiza el agua. Primero el ejercicio que íbamos a hacer no nos permitió para realizar ese gran ejercicio, pero aún ya vamos a empezar con este ejercicio.
Okay. Mamo Rodrigo said we don't have the image of them in the Sierra right now. Mamo Rodrigo said that the mamos and the sagas, they decided to change a little bit due to the technical problems we are having. So what they are going to do now is they are going to play music because the water is intimate, related, or connected with sound. So when they are going to do any ceremony that is a baptism, they need to play music, and this is their music for water. So this is what is happening now.
Io cinque racchime. Guerro, il barro. Mema, sciumba ciri cacico qui. Cacico sana. Togua.
Cacico
sana. Zacchi ne scitto guanga. Come trattare l'acqua per poter bautizzarlos? Allí se necesita estar mamo, se necesita estar saga cuando está haciendo el bautismo.
Okay, dame un tiempito, mamo Rodrigo. First thing, how to treat water in order to use this water to honor the sacredness of water so they could use this water to baptize. For that is required that sagas and mamos need to be present. Okay. Continúa, mamo Rodrigo.
Sí, vamos a permanecer silencios.
We need to keep silent. Everybody needs to be with their eyes closed and silent to honor the water at the moment.
No es que sonido carro, don burro ya o carro ya saca, ya mama. Sí, me cangue, me majona, squaga, squaga, yeca. Cañón, yeca, yeca, yeca. Bueno. Chingiro, chingiro, al quita peyin, guama, es el cigagazis. Yo si squamo qua sin bianche canne canne come vi mai sen canne. Realizando la recolección de materiales para realizar pagamentos.
At the moment in the Sierra, sagas and mamos who are gathered around the water to perform the baptism of water. They are collecting materials. When they say materials, sometimes it could be tumas. In this case, will be jirakuchi tumas. But materials can also be spiritual materials, which are gathered by visualization. So at this moment, even if we are not seeing them, the sagas and the mamos are visualizing jirakuchi tumas, which are water tumas, and other things that they are visualizing as an offering to the water herself. These things that they are visualizing at the moment that are not material physical things are things that has meaning for them and are things that are like blessings or gift that they are offering to the water herself. So one of the things that they offer very sacred for them are tumas. Tumas are pre-Columbian pieces of quartz that they were left in the Sierra Nevada for their ancestors, for the mamos and sagas to continue doing ceremony and offerings to planet Earth. These are century-old pieces of quartz. The ones that are in alignment with the water element are clear pieces of quartz, and they are called jirakuchi. So at the moment, this is offering in the Sierra to baptize as a present, as a gift from the sagas and the mamos to the water.
Yang abun jamin sajit kuj. Iwa meji teruan jamin sajit kuj. Masikan yu kawan kumuk.
And even that we might not know how a water tuma or jirakuchi tuma looks like, is our intention and the willingness of our hearts to offer the best of us to the water as a way that we are doing this to acknowledge and recognize the sacredness of water. So even if we don't have jirakuchi tumas, we could, with our pure intentions, join the mamos in the Sierra.
Bueno, tradicionalmente, culturalmente, bajo de las consultas, para hacer la música con la caja no se debe realizar por el motivo de las tormentas. Que existe, está habiendo tormentas muy fuertes, lo cual no se puede entregar con pagamentos, con tambor.
Okay. Mamo Rodrigo is saying that they are modifying the official ceremony for the water, and there is a reason for that. Normally, there will be drumming, but due to the storm that they are having in the Sierra at this moment, is not allowed for them to drum when there is a storm happening at the same time. So no drumming for the moment.
Can you make that main clear, Yanga? Zun kaji tunes tuna naya na senek. Metetetete main ket. Agar main yung kunaya kinaya. Por este haciendo ahorita acabamos a hacer el baño de niños, entonces ya van yendo las sagas por el motivo de fuertes aguas, está muy cerca, fuertes tormentas. Entonces acabamos de hacer el término, por lo cual los mamos lavan la saga y la saga mama lava a los mamos. Eso es la norma que se hace después de bautismo.
Ok, espera un minuto, Mamo Rodrigo, para traducir eso. At the moment in the Sierra, even that we are not seeing that, there was an exchange of water by the mamos and the sagas. Beginning with the sagas bathing the mamos, not a full bath, just pouring water on top of the mamos, and vice versa, the mamos doing the same towards the saga. That represents or symbolizes like what we do when we baptize a newborn, that we put water on the head. That's exactly what happened between sagas and mamos. First, the sagas, because they are in alignment with the water. The female is in alignment with the water. So the saga began pouring water on top of the heads of the mamos. And the mamos did the same after they finished to the sagas. Continúa, Mamo Rodrigo. Mamo Rodrigo, ¿estás ahí? Mamo Rodrigo said that this is going to be not the end, but we are very close to do, you know, closure to the ceremony. So I'm waiting for him to give me the last words. He was saying before that, he was saying before that the fact that we have a storm, a tropical storm, while we were doing this baptism of the water is relevant. And the fact that we were having this storm was what didn't allow them to do the drumming. But for them, this was not a negative sign. On the contrary, it was a good sign. I'm waiting for the mamos to give me the final instructions. I know that the ceremony is almost about to end because also the energy is dropping. The energy of the ceremony itself is, you know, decreasing momentum. So I know. Is about to close. I'm waiting for his final words. Well, obviously we have lost them. I just wanted to wait a little bit, but even that we don't see them, the ceremony was completed. I had the inner knowing that it was closed and is complete now because the way I feel. I know that they are going to give me a full report after we finished this Zoom call. It was a pity that we were not able to see the entire ceremony, but I truly believe that things always happen for a reason. And I'm humble enough to accept whatever is going on, whatever it is. So I know that they will give me a report of the whole ceremony, and I will write that down to and give it to Shelly and to Jan, and I'm sure they will keep all of you in the loop. They will share that report with you. I don't know if Shelly and Jan want to close up the ceremony because it was energetically, it is complete. I can say that because I know that. So just to do a small recap, the reason why the mamos considered that it was very important for them to fully support the Global Alliance for a World Water Law, it is because they recognize the importance of water, and they not only recognize that, they join and they acknowledge the fact that it has to change the way water is treated in the planet. And there was also something that happened at the very beginning when the mamos were inviting all wisdom keepers to join the circle of wisdom keepers in support of the World Water Law. And this is something that they are fully and truly invested in this movement. So this is basically what it is. And I'm sure I will get a report, and then I will report back to Shelly and Yang, and I'm know for sure they will share all of that with you, with all the people who were participant of this baptism of water.